I got interested in aviation about midway through college. I was at the University of Oregon, and I was wanting to learn another language to try and be a flight attendant. I realized about halfway through college that I could apply myself a little more, get, you know, be more educated and try and be a pilot. Earlier in the morning, so I'll get up 2 or 3 hours before I need to be at the airport, do my planning. If I need to make a flight plan, I'll look at the weather, see what the trends are, make a flight plan based on that. I would also study up my maneuvers, whether it's to the different takeoffs and landings, whatever that lesson is for the day, make sure I know how to perform them and then actually doing it as well. There's a lot of knowledge you need to know, whether it's rules and regulations, airspace, procedures, emergencies, for example. We do what's called chair flying, so you'll be in a chair, pretending that you're just pushing and pulling what you need to do, press what you need to do, and replicate being in the aircraft. So that way, it's more of like a muscle memory technique, because you might know something, know the procedure, and the minute you get into the airplane, you freeze up. I've always been into being a little different, and so getting into a male-dominated industry was definitely appealing to me. I think women are just as capable. They just need to believe in themselves, not feel so intimidated, and just do it. It's not intimidating by any means. People are very friendly. They want you to succeed, if anything, and so that camaraderie is really important. It's okay if you're not perfect. That's not the name of the game. It's just staying on top of it, you know, getting back up and keep going at it, and you will be successful.